I know she sees them.
I
Lutheran Church of the Brethren. It's my special joy to be able to extend our welcome to the students and staff from Cal Poly Pomona, the guest singers and musicians, and to all the friends, family, and music lovers that have gathered for this concert. We're delighted to welcome you to this space, and we're so glad we're able to do it in person. A quick bit of housekeeping, our restrooms are located both ends of the narthex lobby area as you enter the church. They're naked men and women, if you can use whichever's comfortable for you. In addition to the exits in the narthex where you came in, there's exits in the front of the sanctuary in case of emergency. As a church, we had numerous conversations about appropriate protocols related to COVID for tonight's concert. We want you to know that all of the unmasked members of the choir and orchestra performing this evening have tested negative for COVID. As a gesture of mutual respect for the singers and orchestra members, and for the well-being of us all, we recommend that audience members who are able to please wear a mask. You may obtain a mask from any usher. Again, our sincere welcome to each of you this evening, and we hope this will be the beginning of sharing many rich concert experiences together.
Dr. Nikki St. Clair, and as Director of Choral Activities at the Cal Poly Pomona College just down the street, and the Choir Director of the Sanctuary Choir of this very church, it is my distinct pleasure to welcome you into this beautiful space tonight. This concert is long overdue. I planned a large-scale performance right here with the Cal Poly Combined Choirs in, you guessed it, spring of 2020. Of course, that never came to fruition due to the disruption of the COVID-19 pandemic. Tonight, we are presenting compositions by 19th and 20th century French composers Gabriel Fauré and Maurice Dudufle. As boys, they each started their musical careers in church choirs and eventually moved on to master the pipe organ. Both became influential composers of their time, and both remained in the service of the church their entire lives. They were each highly critical of their own works, therefore they left a relatively small output. Both went against contemporary romantic ideals of composing for large orchestral forces for big dramatic effects. Instead, they preferred smaller, more focused efforts and more intimate presentations. Our first set features songs that were composed for liturgical purposes to be performed in church services. Dudufle's Ubi Caritas celebrates gathering in the body of Christ. Two songs by Fauré will follow. Both are quiet but fervent prayers directed to Christ from whence may come one strength, hope, and steadfast faith.
Thank you.
second half of the concert is going to be a Fori's Requiem. A requiem is a funeral mass for the departed. Fori's contemporaries composed big, dramatic requiems that offered visions of the terrors to come after the earthly life. Fori, however, like Brahms, Fori's contemporary, German contemporary, sought to create a funeral mass to comfort the living, people who are left behind. He saw death as a happy deliverance, an aspiration towards the happiness of the hereafter, rather than as a painful passing away. For this reason, Fori's setting is remarkably subdued, with soft dynamics and slow tempos. He omits entirely a part of the traditional text with its visions of wrath and hellfire, and adds the beautiful and soft pie Jesu and in parentis movements 4 and 7 that are not part of the Requiem proper. These two movements emphasize the granting of eternal rest. I want to share with you, in Fori's own words, his reason for adding these movements. It has been said, Fori says, that my Requiem does not express the fear of death. And someone has called it a lullaby of death. But it is thus that I see death as a happy deliverance, an aspiration towards happiness above, rather than as a painful experience. I have also instinctively sought to escape from what is thought right and proper after all the years of accompanying burial services of the organ. I wanted to write something different. Fori's work is dominated from beginning to end by a very human feeling of faith in eternal rest. His Requiem is gentle as Fori was himself, and invites quiet reflection and contemplation. We dedicate this performance to the thousands who passed away these last 2 years. May their souls rest in eternal peace, and the memory of each one become a blessing for us all.